always said, if you dream hard enough, it will happen. And if you really, really push hard enough for your dreams, it will come true. Somehow I got sidetracked somewhere along the line and ended up as a hostess for 10 years. But then I met orangutans. They're just so much like us that you can't help falling in love with them. And also they have this very gentle streak. And then I finally decided to quit my job. And that's when my little dream started that maybe we should do something on our own. But it took 2 years of hard work trying to raise money, which didn't happen. You know, Lone from Denmark, ex-air hostess, yeah, doesn't raise a lot of money for a conservation project. We started in the beginning of 1999, getting the permits through, starting the building, and we opened in November 1999 with the first orangutans. The reason why this project was set up here in Palangkaraya was because during my time down in Tanjung Puting, I noticed that most of the orangutans that were brought in from confiscations or people brought in voluntarily, they came from Palangkaraya. And it turned out to be a good place for it because, I mean, in less than 2 years we got 80, 85 orangutans. The selling goes straight by our nose here down the rivers. I mean, all the babies are going by here. What happens is the loggers that are in the forest doing their legal logging, they'll encounter a female orangutan with a baby. They'll shoot her. There's protein for them to eat, the mother, and then if the baby survives the fall, they will take it. They know that they can get good money for it. The latest we've heard from the United States for a wild born is $30,000. Some people think it's more prestigious maybe to have a wild born. Most of the ones that are in the quarantine in Jakarta has been confiscated either in Jakarta or any other bigger towns on Jawa, either Yogyakarta, Bogor, Surabaya, Semarang, and they're normally shipped to Jakarta and then from there either to Varanasi or to here. Thank you.
are you?
Bobo is definitely, he's in very, very good shape. His hair is very beautiful. You can only see it on the skin and the hair whether they're in fairly good health.
He's got huge hands. Huh? Tangan dia besar sekali.
Yeah. Uh-uh. Namanya belum ada.
Belum ada?
Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah. Dia paling kalau udah digendong, wah suka banget.
Oh, they're in very good health, both of them. Very good health. The little one is a little bit overweight, but that I put down to being fed the wrong milk.
The Putu, he was confiscated in Bali.
Oh, yeah?
This has a Putu Bali. The Putu Bali, yeah? Huh? The compass. Oh, das ist das richtige. Guck mal.
They always grab the wrong
das
things.
Das ist ja nur nicht das richtige.
No.
Tari pagi.
Ja, ja.
Surely some of them were having fun up on the these painted poles, but it didn't quite resemble a forest very much. Well, I never met Ulla before, so that was definitely an experience, but I was also a bit disillusioned about seeing all these smaller orangutans just being playing around on the ground, and I would rather see them coming here and getting out in the forest than and being where they are.
So, also fine.
Thank you very much.
It just makes me really, really sad and very, very, sick at heart, I guess you can call it, to see this. They're overweight, they're bored out of their skull, there's nothing for them to do. The little enrichment they have is totally, nobody has thought it through about what they've done. They've done these two little houses on the island, what can they use that for?
Yeah, give me some more so I can get fatter.
I mean, there's nothing for them to do. They just sit and eat and get fed by stupid white people also, for that matter. But especially the Indonesian will throw cigarettes and everything at them. We have transported now 11 from Jakarta to here. They're fairly experienced with it now, Merpati, the local airline, yeah, so it's not normally a problem. The ones who never come and ask, they might think that I'm having an orangutan as a pet, which is really what I wanted to try to avoid. But once they see it, I mean, that's it, what can you do? But at least the ones who ask, you can explain that it's going to go back to the forest. It's a project. That was, I think, the first time it's actually been done. This is the very first time that a small baby has been carried inside the cabin. And that was quite a bit of an experience.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Come on in, Captain Baba. Hello. I'm in Santara. Come show for this local train. Here is the number and 3514. The flight will take you direct to Palangkaraya. I don't know exactly where they came from, but it looks to me as if they come from fairly wealthy families. Somebody who's taken very good care of them. I've had others coming in situations where they have been like close to death, where they come in so skinny, there was, I mean, it's just only skin and bones left on them. One would only eat newspapers. It was all that you eat because you had been thrown under the house. Maybe just to compete with the dogs. She was just another animal, so you stay under the house and will feed you scraps just like the dogs. Right. And she never won, I guess.
If you have a continuous flow in the project, what would happen is that the orangutan arrives, goes through a medical checkup within a couple of days of their arrival. We normally let them settle down just a little bit first. Then we'll take their blood, do the other medical examination.
can't be equal.
The blood will be sent off to Jakarta, where they will test for hepatitis A, B, C, and tuberculosis. When that comes back, the result, which only takes a couple of days, if they're all negative, we will normally put them together with other orangutans.
I'm sorry, it doesn't hurt that much. You're too fat. That's why it hurts.
Bobo, the larger male, I think he will do really well. He seems to have a bit of a wild streak in him. I would give him about 6 months and we'll probably move him out to the island. He's too eager to go. He's going to be one of those that are going to be really difficult to assess here first, because he's very, very bitey, he's quite aggressive. So we might just move him straight out to the island and just hope he will do well. If he doesn't, we'll have to tranquilize him and pull him back in again. He obviously hasn't been out very much outside. He's been held inside a house because his skin is very white. That's again, once he's here, he'll get out and socialize.
Hi, Mr. Thiessen.
Jerry, jangan, Dad. Jerry, Jerry, tak boleh. Jerry, jangan gigit orang. Ambil Jerry. Dia mau gigit. Hey. Ned, Ned. Nanti tidak gigit, tapi apa Jerry?
Is it too dangerous? 6 months old. He'll be in baby school until he's about two. Then he'll be removed out in a midway house. Normally in the wild, he'll be with the mothers up until the age of seven. Then she'll get pregnant again and then she'll start pushing her baby away.
Maybe tomorrow morning would have been if they do climb a bit higher. The problem is when I come out, they very often come down.
They have been releasing orangutans at around four. I think it's too young. I would like to wait until five or six, but definitely not younger than four. So that means somebody like Tim would have 3.5 years left here.
You are such a whitey you are. You've never been out in the sun, have you? You need to get some sun in that little face.
Want some of these?
Dad, you have your own. Hmm. Oh, open this and get it. Oh. Wait. Hmm. They don't really want to play with you anyway, do they? No?
First of all, they're taken away from the family that who has cared for them for maybe five, six years, and then put into a cage, an environment that they've never seen before.
Right.
All these new people suddenly feeding them fruit, where they used to get human food,
right.
And then eventually meeting other orangutans, yeah. Especially when they're young, they're very, very social, actually. Except that some are loners. Some of them really has that very sort of instinct for being solitary.
Kenapa saya? Itu nak minum. Minum.
Yuk. Turut. Ayo, Bu. Mak dia tengku lo.
Hey, Yuni. Yuni. Saya pencet apa tu merah.
Terasih ya.
Jangan digigit.
Thank you.
The idea is that if they're less than 2 years old, two and a half years old, we'll keep them here at the baby school, which is out in the forest from 7 o'clock in the morning until 4 o'clock in the afternoon. The personalities are sometimes more important than their age. We had a 7-year-old in the baby school, which is really only for the tiny babies, because she was like, in a really bad stage when she came. First of all, she couldn't walk, she couldn't do anything. She needed special training. Take a big group out, they very often start play fighting on the ground and won't take up to the trees. But if you've got one that's really good in the trees and one that's a bit lazy, who doesn't really know what the trees are for, the one that's a bit lazy would follow the one that climbs the trees.
We really only do this to her when we have to tranquilize her for other reasons, like that she escapes.
Oh yes, that happens once in a while. But it gives us a good chance to actually see how those orangutans that do escape, how they do in the forest, because they take to the trees immediately. and then we can sort of assess their skills, whether they later would be suitable to move out to a bigger forest. The oldest one is Dagoy, the Escalive. She's about 14 years old. We've seen her out a lot of times. She does quite well in the trees. The people who took care of her, they had her for 12 years. But now that she has grown older, her instincts are getting more like a wild orangutan. She wants to go out there and meet a male. And she's becoming more and more aggressive towards us also. It's like, I don't want to be here anymore. I want to go out there and have a kid. And I'm sure that we will put her on the island. She's going to take really good care of herself.
Jen! Hey. Jen, Jen!
Jen! Jen! Hey! Jen!
Maybe one of them would even make a nest. Some of them are capable of making nests, even though they've never been taught. They've been in cages since they were tiny. And now they're like 5-6 years old. And of course, then you have the problem that they don't have any forest skills. But you can see they can climb trees, obviously. It's like an instinct. And sometimes the nest making is very much an instinct also.
Kalau ada sebenarnya tali yang seperti di kapal itu.
Bukan ya, tapi itu harus mereka bilang apa? Saya bicara sama Ian, dia bilang harus ada yang ada seperti bukan yang biasa yang di putar-putar seperti itu. Ah, cium-cium apa? Ibu. Ah, cium-cium.
Siapa ini katanya?
Iya, selah.
Sen,
titik.
Halo.
Sen,
yuk sana.
Between 2 to maybe 4.5 years old, again depending on the personalities, because you can have a 4-year-old that's extremely bullish, will be at the Midway House facility, which is more or less just training also.
Pakisa is one. She broke her arm. She fell out of the tree and landed straight on a big, big log. Broke her arm. 2 weeks after she'd broken it, it was all healed. And 1 month later, we had her back in the forest again. We cannot eat this, okay, guys? No, no.
Ngantuk kali dia tuh nah. Di luar ini.
Yamhead over there that you're filming right now, he also broke his arm. Went down and broke his arm. He was 3 weeks later, after he had broken it, he was out climbing trees again.
No. She's seeing if there's somebody inside.
No.
Having a look.
No.
Just having a look.
If they want to sleep out at night, if they want to make their own nests, they're free to do that. If they want to come in and sleep in cages at night, we've got big holding cages, then they can do that. But they're out, definitely out from 7 o'clock until 4 every day. And then if we find that they have forest skills that are good enough, that's a personal assessment, something we have to take them out in the forest for a couple of days, see how they're doing, they're not falling out of the trees all the time. Then we'll move them on to Katja Island, where they'll be free to roam. Those ones who cannot so much be trained in this forest, because this forest is very, very small diameter trees and will break under the weight of the bigger ones, they will go on the island. Of course, because they're older, they also have a stronger instinct for returning to the wild. The island can take probably about 30, maximum 30. I would like to keep it down to about 20, 25, but if I have to, we can put 30 onto the island. That means that gives me a little bit more room here again. The problem is, and we're stuck again, we'll still end up with orangutans in those large holding cages because we can't keep on moving them out to the island. So there will always be some that are going to not lose out, but they're going to have to wait to get out into their natural environment. Once we have a release site, you can have that smooth flow going through the center, but as long as we don't have a release site, we're a little bit stuck. The problem is in central Kalimantan right now, there's hardly any forest left that fulfills the criteria for a release site. Well, first of all, a botanical survey have to be seen whether the food supply is big enough. Secondly, there must not be wild orangutans. And that's actually quite difficult to find an area of forest in central Kalimantan that doesn't have orangutans, because they have been pushed into areas where they usually wouldn't have been. And even there, a lot of them are dying off because the food is not plentiful enough. We're looking into areas up towards the mountains also, even though that's not a prime habitat for orangutans. But we might be able to release a smaller number. But again, on a long term, genetically, it's not going to work, is it? Maybe it's going to die off.
Darling.